Right. I guess we'll all get settled and start over. I was just talking about how different it feels to be over here versus on the other side. We're just 40 feet apart, but the sounds are different, the sight is different, the whole energy feels different. So let's start again with the sounds. So you sit down on your mat, you close your eyes. I'd like it to pick up as many sounds as you can. There's a lot going on this morning. A lot. Identify the sounds and in your mind really name them. What are you hearing? That's my voice. That's a really obnoxious leaf blow in the back. I have to use all my yoga skills not to get mad at that person right now. That's the music. What else? What can you pick up? I'd like you to take a deep, long breath in through the nose. Open your mouth and exhale. Deep, long breath in through the nose. Open your mouth and sigh it out. Deep, long breath in. Open mouth and sigh it out. Now turn your attention how this place feels. Keep your eyes closed. If you've never been here before, never practiced with us before, just feel into the space. If you normally practice with us and you're over with us on the other side, how does this feel different? Now take another deep breath in through the nose. This time pull the shoulders up towards the ears. And as you exhale, open your mouth. Let the shoulders sink down. Deep breath in. Pull the shoulders up towards the ears. And exhale, let it sink down. One more like that. Pull it up and this time hold it. Hold the breath, maybe add a little bit more air, squeeze everything up, make everything super tight, look up at the sky, open the mouth and let it go. Now take a deep breath in through the nose. Close your mouth, take a long breath out through the nose. Deep breath in. And a long breath out. Keep your eyes closed and with your next inhale, bring your arms overhead in a big circle. Bring those palms to touch. With your exhale, bring the hands down in front of your chest. I'll open the class with a chant of 3 Aums. You can chant with me or just listen in, whatever's more comfortable. Deep inhale. If you would like to set an intention for your class, now is a good time. Think of the question, why did I show up this morning? How do I want to feel after this class? How do I want to feel during this class? What would I like to have in my life right now? Bow your chin down to your chest. Focus on that intention, whatever it may be. Another deep breath in. And another smooth breath out. Then bring the head back up and we'll start our class. Bring the hands up overhead. Look at your hands. And as you exhale, arms come down by your side. Big wide circle through the middle. Hands pressed together. Bring them up overhead. Look at those hands. Exhale, wide circle. Hands to your side, chin to your chest. One last time. Hands together. Really press them in. Look up. Press the arms together, reach up as high as you can, hold here. And then exhale, let it flow down to the side. Hands stay on your side, bring your chin down to your chest. Let your head hang heavy. You can move your hands a little bit to the front or to the back. Intensify that stretch. And then with an inhale, bring your head all the way up. Look at the sky. Let your head fall to the back, close your mouth. And a couple of times back and forth, chin down with your exhale, head up with your inhale. Chin down with your exhale, look up at the sky with your inhale. Move at your own pace, check into your neck, and then bring your head back to center. We're gonna look over our left shoulder and bring it all the way over to the right. Slow back and forth. Keep those fingertips on the floor, arms are strong. One fluid movement, left to right. Very good, bring your head back straight. And we're gonna bring our left ear to the left shoulder and bring our head all the way up and over, right ear to the right shoulder. Back and forth, leading the head to the right and leaning the head to the left. And now a couple of half revolutions or full revolutions with your neck. If you're comfortable, keep your eyes closed. Feel into that neck, feel into any tightness or tension you may feel. You know that just you're practicing this morning with me, everything I'm saying is just a suggestion. If you find something else that feels good in your body, do that. You should never feel any pain, never feel any strain. Bring the head back to center, both arms overhead. Exhale, cactus those arms. Bring those shoulder blades in the back to touch, press the elbows back, strong fingers here. Maybe look up at the sky, maybe there's a slight smile on your face. For this beautiful day, inhale, reach up with both arms, right hand on the left knee, left hand behind you, twist, walk that back hand as close to your buttocks as you can, relax your shoulders down, look all the way over your left shoulder, and then with an inhale, bring both arms overhead, and we slowly move to the other side, left hand on the right knee, right hand behind you, walk that back hand as close in as you can. Remember, there's no pushing, there's no pulling. Use the strength in your torso. Both arms overhead with your inhale. Bring your right hand down to the mat. Left arm reaches up and over. Right hand down to the mat, left arm up and over. There you go. Really reach with that left arm. See whether you can bring that left bicep as close to your ear as you can. And now we go left to right, over to the left side. Reach with that right arm up and over. And one smooth motion, over to the right. Back and forth. Make that motion as fluid as you can. If you notice any area where your spine feels tight, maybe stay in that area. Think of a leaf in the water, fluid, going with the stream. Very good. Both arms reach back up. Cactus those arms one more time. And then we reach up, bring the hands in front of you, roll forward to a tabletop position. Now in your tabletop, bring your wrists underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips. Tuck your toes this morning, all 10 toes tucked. And then we start with a couple of cat and cows. With an inhale, look up, tailbone up, belly down. Exhale, round the spine. Press your tailbone down. Bring your chin to your chest. Don't forget to breathe back and forth with your own breath. Inhale, look up, tailbone up, press it, belly down. Exhale, rounds the spine. Can go as fast or as slow as it feels good in your body. Feel out your spine. Try to notice without any judgment whether there's any tightness, any congestion, or any area that feels really good this morning. Two more like that. And then bring your hands, one handprint to the front, dancing lion. Any movement that feels good here. Move your hips around, move your shoulders around. Again, if you're comfortable, close your eyes. Go inside. Notice how it feels in your body this morning. If you haven't already, change your direction. Find those tight spots, find those tight places. Very good. And then we come back to center. Walk your wrists back underneath your shoulders. Toes are tucked. With your next inhale, lift your knees up. Only a little bit. Press through those arms. Press through those hands. Feel your thighs starting to work. Feel your back starting to work. Two more breaths here. Slow and smooth. And then we set it back down. Sit back on those heels. Toes are still tucked. If this is too intense, you can always untuck the toes or put a block in between your legs. Inhale, arm, bring your arms up overhead. Exhale, cactus those arms. Feel those toes. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, cactus the arms. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands forward. With your inhale, knees cleave the mat again. Breathe here. Just activating the core. Making sure all of the muscles know that we need them. One more breath here. And then press your hips up and back for your first downward facing dog. Pedal through your legs. Bend into one knee. Bend into the other knee. Shift away left and right. When you're ready, come to stillness. Your heels may make it to the floor or not, doesn't matter. Point your tailbone up and back. Allow your neck to relax. Shake your head, yes. Shake your head, no. Couple of circles with that neck. And then take a slow stroll to the top of the mat. Slow, slow, slow. And as you arrive forward, make sure all 10 toes point forward, feet are parallel, hip distance apart. Clasp your hands to your elbows. Sway side to side. Allow your head to relax down. See how this feels in your lower back. Your hamstrings just warming up, just noticing what's going on in your body. And then release your elbows, put a slight bend in your knee, and with an inhale, roll all the way up. Take it slow. As your head lifts, arms overhead, circle the sun. Exhale, chair pose. Sit down and back in your chair. Hands can come in front of your chest. Take a peek down. Feet should be parallel. You should be able to see your toes. Can you sit a little bit further down? Can you point your tailbone towards the heels? Can we take another breath here? And we straighten the leg back out. Big inhale, slight back bend here. Exhale, fold it forward. Lift halfway. Exhale, fold. Step it back to a plank pose. High push-up. High up on the balls of your feet. One line of energy between the heels and the crown of your head. We're not going to stay here long. Find your breath. Slow float all the way down to the mat. Untuck those toes. Inhale, baby cobra or full cobra. Lift your chest. Don't forget to breathe. Press the tops of the feet into the mat. Roll your shoulders back. And then exhale, release. Press it back to child's pose. Close-legged or wild-legged, just one breath here. And then back forward to a tabletop position. Pick your left knee up. I'm not going to mirror you. A couple of circles with that left knee. And reverse the direction. And then bring that left leg all the way to the back of the mat. Point those toes down. Strengthen up that foot. Push through the heel. Strong leg. Take a peek down. Make sure your wrists are under your elbows. There you go. Great adjustments. Keep those toes pointed down. Engage your buttocks. Bring the weight into your left hand. Reach forward with your right hand. Always an option to bring that hand back down. Focus here. Breathe. Right hand comes back down. Left leg goes out to the left side. Tap it back down and bring it all the way over to the right. Back and forth a couple of times. And then bring that left foot all the way out to the left. We walk our hands in. Bring them to the hips. Press those hips forward. Bring the foot all the way out to the side, not to the front. There you go. Arms overhead with an inhale. Left hand down the leg. Right arm reaches up and over. You're going that way. Breathe here. Press those hips forward. Straighten out the upper arm. Breathe here. And then bring that right hand down to the mat. Lift that left arm up. Bring it over your head. Reach to that side. There you go. Fantastic. Breathe here. With one big inhale, all the way back up. Hands down to the mat. Bring that left knee back in. One round of cat-cow. How's that feel? So we've moved the hip around. And tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Step the right foot in between your hands, left leg is back, bring the left knee down. Untuck the toes, inhale, arms up. Exhale, cactus those arms. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands down to the mat, and we floss it out. Go back and forth. See how that right leg feels as you go back. Feel how that left hip flexor feels as you come forward. Slow movements here. Feel into that body. And then as we come forward, bring the weight into that right foot. Step the left foot to the front. Reach down with your arms. Bend into those knees. Bend into those knees a lot. Bring your belly down to the thighs. And then see whether you can bring the weight into the heels and come up to a chair pose. There you go. Different way to go about it. See whether you can bring your arms up. Fantastic. Excellent. Stay here in your chair. Let your hips sink down. Smoothen out your breath. And then with one inhale all the way up. Add a back bend and we go right in the other side. Exhale, fold forward. Lift halfway, inhale. Step it back to a plank pose. High push-up. If you lose your breath, if you need a break, it's always okay to put the knees down, to take a child's pose. It's not about pushing through. It's about listening to your body, what you need this morning. With one slow exhale, float it down to the mat. Inhale, baby cobra or full cobra. Press into those hands, roll those shoulders back and down. There you go. Breathe here. Push the tops of the feet down. Engage your buttocks here. Strong arms, one more breath. Exhale, bring it down to the mat. Press it back to a child's pose with a slow inhale. Make a choice here. You can take a break here, or you can follow along with me. If you want to take a break, just stay in your child's pose. If you want to follow on, come forward to a tabletop. Pick your right knee up, a couple of circles. Change direction. And bring that right leg all the way to the back of the mat. Push through that heel. Point the toes down. Really strengthen up that back leg. If I came around and I was trying to push it down, I couldn't. It's so strong. Weight into the right hand. Left arm forward. Reach here. Always an option to leave that hand down on the mat if it feels more stable. Find your focal point. Breathe. Slow and deep. And then bring that left hand down. Bring the right leg out to the right side. Tap it down. And all the way back over to the left side. Couple of circles. Back and forth. Not important how fast you go. More important to really feel out that range of motion. Then set that foot over to the right. Really anchor it down. Press the outside of that foot down really strong. Walk the hands in. Bring them to your hips. Press those hips slightly forward. Take a look down. You should have one line here between your legs. Straighten out that knee. Hands to the hips. Great modification. Fantastic. That's what we want. Hips forward. Arms up. Right arm down to the side. Left arm up and over. You're going that way. Really feel that stretch on your outer left hip. See whether you can straighten out that left arm, bicep towards the ear. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Left hand down to the mat, to the floor, right arm up and over towards that side. Breathe here. One big inhale, we come back up. Hands down to the mat. Bring that right knee in. One round of cat-cow. However it feels good for you. Maybe you stay in your cat, maybe you stay in your cow. And then walk your hands forward for a puppy pose. Hips stay high. Arms reach forward. Forehead down to the floor or to a block. Breathe here. In through the nose. Out through the mouth. In through the nose. Out through the mouth. I love it when I see you guys making adjustments. It needs to feel good in your body. The birds are saying the same thing. We're all different people. All of our bodies are different. It's no wonder that everybody has their unique expression when it comes to yoga poses. Very slowly walk your hands back from your puppy pose to a tabletop. Bring your left hand underneath your face. Reach up with your right arm. Look at that right hand. Couple of circles with that arm to the front. Use the whole arm as if you were swimming. There you go. And reverse the direction. See how your body feels now that we've warmed up. And then reach up with that right arm. Bring that right arm underneath. Right shoulder comes down to the mat. Press the back of that right hand into the mat. Left hand can stay in front of your face. Or you can reach it forward. Breathe here. Make sure your hips are equal, you're not leaning to one side or the other. So what we want to do here is bring that shoulder up. There you go. That's the movement. And in terms of the hips, you want to make sure you're not rotating your hips. There you go. That's it. Does that feel good?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Can you reach with your arm a little bit more here? There you go. There you go. And now take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, I'm going to bring that shoulder up. There you go. Beautiful. One more breath here. Feel your heartbeat. Slow down your breath. Slow down your thoughts. The next inhale, bring that left arm back in front of the face, press in back to tabletop. Any movements here, cat cow, dancing lion, feel into those shoulders. And then we'll do the other side, left hand in front of the face. Sorry, right hand, left arm up. Look at that left hand. Breathe here. Really see whether you can stack those shoulders. Couple of circles to the front. Couple of circles to the back. And then reach up with that left arm. Reach underneath as far as you can first, and then bring that left shoulder down to the mat. Right hand can stay in front of your face. You can bring it to the small of your back, or you can reach overhead. Find your breath. Check in that your hips are equal. Press the back of that right hand strongly down into the mat. I'll give you an adjustment here if you're okay with that. Is that okay?
Yeah.
So bring that shoulder up. There you go. There you go. That's it. Now can you reach with that arm? That's it. Now stay with your upper body like you are and equal out your hips. There you go. It's perfect. Michelle, that looks absolutely fantastic. Doing a really good job. One more breath here. See what it feels like. Slowing down the breath. Slowing down the heart rate. Bring your left arm back, left hand back in front of your face. Press in. Left arm up. And float it down. Cat, cow, or dancing lion, whatever feels good here. Feel into your neck, feel into your back, feel into your spine, your lower back. And then whenever you're ready, tuck your toes. We're going to go through one more floor. We all meet in downward facing dog. Take your time to arrive there. Pedal through your legs. With your next inhale, reach that right leg up and back. Stretch through the heel. Strong right leg here. Press through the hands. Step the right foot in between your hands. Let back heel is up. Find your stable runner's lunge here first, and then bring the hands on top of the knees. And if you're feeling stable, arms come all the way up. Back heel is charging up. If you walk the heels apart on wide railroad tracks, you're going to have a little more stability. If you walk your feet together in one line, it's a little harder. Arms stay up overhead. Find your focal point. Bend into the front knee. There you guys go. Fantastic. Can we reach all the way up with the arms? Breathe here. Hands come in front of the heart. Can we bring the left elbow outside of the right knee? Press those palms together. Bring them in front of your chest. Bring that right elbow up. Breathe here. Now, can we take one step with the left foot to the front of the mat and stay in our twist? One step forward. Chair pose with a twist. Excellent, you guys. That was a difficult transition. Inhale to the center. Stay in your chair. Exhale to the other side. Now bring the weight into your left foot. Step the right foot to the back of the mat. High lunge. It's okay to take a couple of steps to get there. Find your stability. Hands come to the knee. Arms come over. Exhale, both hands down to the mat. Step it back to plank. Blow it all the way down to the mat. Untuck the toes. Inhale, baby cobra or full cobra. Exhale, release it down. Tuck your toes down, dog. Breathe here. Remember, if you can't take a full deep breath, it's time for a break. Always fine to lower the knees. Take a sip of water. Towel off. Now, if you'd like to continue with me, left leg up and back. Push through the heel. Press through the arms. Step that left foot in between your hands. High lunge. Hands can come on top of the knees first. Get stable through the legs first, and then reach your arms up. Bend into the front knee. Breathe here. Hands come in front of the heart. Twist to your left. Right elbow on top of the left knee. You're all twisting that way. There you go. Bring that elbow down. Press the hands together. Great job. Strengthen that back leg. There you go. Really reach through that back leg. Press that back heel towards the mat. Very good. Now, weight comes into the left foot. One big step, top of the mat. We inhale, chair twist. To the center. Stay in your chair. Challenging flow. I know. Over to the other side. Left hand outside the right knee. Weight comes into the right foot. Step the left foot to the back of the mat. High lunge twist. Find your stability here. Back heel is charging up. Hands to the knee first. Both arms overhead. You guys are doing absolutely fantastic. Exhale, both hands to the mat. Step your right foot to the back. Lower all the way down. Make a little pillow with your hands. Toes come out to the side. Just relax down. Give ourselves a little break here. You need to towel off, towel off. If you're on a sip of water, take a sip of water. It's all cool down time from here onwards. Throw her down to the mat. Go back to your intention. Check in with your body. Start with your intention. Why did you step on your mat? Why did you come here? Then check in with your body. Feel your heartbeat. That was intense work. Can you slow that heartbeat back down? How do we slow the heartbeat down? We work with the breath. Let's take a deep breath in through the nose. Open the mouth and just let it flow out. Deep breath in through the nose and let it go through the mouth. Stay with this breath. See whether you can extend the exhale. And every time you inhale life force energy. Every time you exhale, let go of what you don't need this morning. Inhale. And exhale. Feel how your heartbeat calms down. How your breath calms down. Stay here. or continue the practice with me, whatever feels better for you. If you want to stay, just relax and keep breathing. If you want to continue with me, bring your feet back on straight. Point the toes all the way to the back. Reach your arms forward, palms on the floor. Lift your right leg up, point it, bring it back down. Lift the left leg up, bring it back down. Lift both feet up. Point through the feet, through the tips of your toes. Breathe here. Exhale, bring it all back down. Press the tops of the feet into the floor. Press your pelvis into the floor. Lift the right arm up. Set it back down. Lift the left arm up. And set it back down. Now can we lift both arms up? Leave the feet on the floor. Press the tops of the feet down. You will feel your lower back engage. Breathe here. Exhale back down. Really relax your lower back here. Relax your neck. And then with our next inhale, we're going to lift both arms and both feet off the floor. Deep inhale. Oh. Don't have to go super high. Reach forward with your fingertips. Reach back with the tips of your toes. Don't forget to breathe. Squeeze your buttocks. Use that lower back. And then exhale, everything comes back down. One more round. With your next inhale, lift everything up. This time as high as you can. Stay here. If you want to make this harder, you're going to move your arms to your side and to the front. Slow movements to the side, to the front. Lift those feet up as high as you can. There you go. Great job. One more inhale. One more exhale. Hands down to the mat. Slowly press yourselves back towards a child's pose. Knees as wide as your mat. Big toes to touch. Forehead comes down. Arms can be stretched long, or you can bring your elbows down outside to the outsides of your mat and let your fingertips touch. Allow the back of your head to relax, the neck to relax. Let those hips sink back. Check in with your body. Check in with your breath. And then very slowly, walk your hands back towards your body. Grab your blocks and come to sit on your heels. I got you. That's okay. Take those blocks and bring them back by your heels. So you'll see what kind of height you need, lowest height, medium height, highest height. I suggest we'll start with the highest height. Just put the blocks by your heels. Get a good grip so that they're right here. Okay, and then with our next inhale, we come up. You can tuck your toes or leave them flat on the floor. We're going for a camel pose here. Press your hips forward. Take your hands, put them in your back pocket first. And in our first round, the only thing we're going to do is pressing our hips forward, lifting our chest up, and bringing our head to the back towards the hotel. Breathe here. See whether you can squeeze your shoulder blades together. Squeeze your elbows together. Press those hips forward. Let that head fall back only if it's comfortable. One more breath here. In. And with your exhale, bring your hips back down. Slow movements. Feel into that lower back. Bring those hips forward and backward. Feels good. And we come up on our knees again. Bring that right arm up. Take the left hand. Really pull the right side of your chest forward. And then the right arm goes to the back and see whether you can find that block. Left arm goes up. Really reach with that arm. Go to the back and see whether you can find the block. If the block is too far away or if you're collapsing into your hips, bring the hands back into the back pocket. Press those hips forward. Squeeze the shoulder blades together in the back. You're doing a great job there. Move that a little bit further forward. Now put your hands down. There you go. A little bit more stable. Now push those hips forward. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. There you go. Beautiful. Now if you'd like, let your head fall to the back. Breathe here. That looks fantastic. And oh, you're so beautiful. Very slowly come back out like you came in. First bring the head back. And bring the left arm back. Then the right arm. Slowly sit back on your heels. Check in with those hips. Maybe put your hands on your hips and give yourselves a little movement here. And then we're going to set the blocks to the side. Don't put them too far away. We're going to need them. Legs come out to the front. Bring your feet, soles of the feet together, but don't bring them all the way in. We're going to go halfway so that we have a nice little diamond shape here. Okay? You can hold around your toes here, or you can hold your ankles, whatever is more comfortable. Now, wherever you're holding, find your sit bones first. Sit up really tall. Bring your shoulders down. Bring your shoulders back. Squeeze them together. Slight arch in your lower back. Reach up with the crown of your head. And now keep that back straight as it is. And with your exhale, slowly fold forward. You might just go a little bit forward. That's perfectly fine. Find that edge. No rounding of the back. Keep the shoulder blades to the back. Keep the chest forward. Keep staying here. Couple of breaths. And then let your head relax. Let your upper body round and let everything sink down. Now, if you'd like, you can relax your arms and bring them to the front of the mat. Just let them hang wherever they are. Or for some people, it feels good to bring the arms underneath and around. Just let your upper body hang here. Allow that head to be super heavy. Release through that lower back. The only thing you need to do here is breathe. In and out of the nose. Three more breaths here. And then slowly come back out. Make this super slow. Really roll up one vertebra at a time. Use your hands to bring your knees back together. Hands come behind you. Fingers facing forward. Soles of the feet flat on the mat, as wide as your mat. We're going to release our hips here. Go over to the right. Set your knees all the way down. On each side. It's okay if your hip lifts up, but we really want to work through our hips here. See how that hip feels as you come down with that knee all the way. Very good. Now bring your both soles of the feet flat to the floor. Bring the block by your side. You're going to need it. Bring your strap by your side. You're going to need it. And then feet are hip distance apart. Arms are reaching forward. Bring your knees parallel and lower down onto your back. I'm not going to count you down. Hold yourself accountable. Take it slow. No flopping. Doesn't matter how fast your neighbor is going. Slow, slow, slow. And when you arrive down on the mat, bring your knees into your chest. Give yourself a little squeeze here. Maybe rock side to side. Then bring both soles of the feet down to the mat. Walk them as close to your buttocks as you can. Grab a block. And then as you lift your hips up, slide that block underneath for an assisted bridge pose. You can have the low height or the medium height. Whatever feels good here. Right underneath your tailbone. Yeah, you got it? Yeah. It's probably a little bit too far. Slide it a little forward. And you know what? I'm going to bring it one height up for you. So you can actually do it. There you go. Bring it down. Okay. Now you can stay here. Or if you'd like, you can stretch one leg out to the front. If you do that, and the other leg, bring it down to the floor. See how that feels. If that gets too intense, walk the feet back in. Next option is to bring your arms overhead. One arm or both arms, see how this feels. If this is too intense in your lower back, back out, adjust the block. Let go of your shoulders here. Let go of your hips. Bring special attention to your hip flexors and your buttocks. See whether there's any tension in there that you can release. If your knees fall out to the side a little bit, that's fine. If your arms are not reaching straight overhead, but on a 45 degree angle, that's fine. Where can you relax? Where can you release? Where can you let go? Two more breaths here. Now walk the feet slowly back towards your body. Adjust the block so that it is straight underneath your tailbone. I recommend the lowest height, but you can also have the medium height for this and bring your legs straight up for an assisted waterfall pose. See how this feels on your back. Any adjustments with the block? Yep, completely straighten out your knees. There you go, that's it. And if it's hard to hold those legs up, let me know and I'll give you the strap. Can be a little helpful. Any movements with those feet, with those ankles. Can also let your right leg fall out to the right side, left leg fall out to the left side if that feels good. How does it feel to inverse the blood flow here? To let everything flow back to the earth from your legs. Now bring your knees into your chest and bring that block to the side. Just wiggle it out there. Happy baby is next. Grab the outer edges of your right foot and left foot. There you go. If reaching for the outer edges of your feet doesn't feel good, you can again catch a hold of your ankles or the back of your thighs. Relax your neck. Relax your neck. Relax your neck right here. There you go. Breathe. See whether you can bring your whole spine to the floor in this pose. Start with the back of your head. Press it down. Release the back of your neck to the floor. The shoulders, the upper back, the mid back. Press your lower back down. And then see whether you can point your tailbone straight forward to the ocean. Bring it further down. Breathe here. Your arms are working, your legs are working. Can you relax everything else? Mm-hmm. And let go of your legs. Bring the knees into the chest one more time. Arms out to a T, knees to a 90 degree angle. We're gonna finish with a twist over to the right. So set your knees simply over to the right. Allow your shoulders to stay on the mat. Allow your knees to relax down. There you go. The more you bring the knees towards your chest, the more intense that stretch will be. Go and put a block here. See how that feels. Relax your knees down. Relax everything down. Relax. Relax that knee down. There you go. Wait. Press into your arms, bring those knees back up, and simply set them over to the other side. You can use blocks, you don't have to. Keep your shoulders on the mat, allow your spine to relax, allow your hips to relax. So we're slowing down here. Check in with your body one more time. With an inhale, come back to center. If there's any last pose your body is craving for, go for it. If not, set the blocks to the side and release into your final resting pose, final shavasana. Stretch those legs out long. Let the feet fall out to the side. Press your shoulders away from your ears. Let those arms fall wherever they are. Would it feel better right now to have your palms facing up or facing down? Make a choice here. Roll the back of your head a little bit side to side to release any remaining tension. Go back to your intention that you have set for your class. The next couple of breaths, feel all of those points where your body is connected to the floor. The back of your legs, your buttocks, lower back, mid back, upper back and shoulders. Feel all of those points where your body is touching the mat or touching the floor. Now with every exhale, feel yourself melting a little bit deeper into that mat. There's nothing you have to do other than to just let the breath flow in and out of your body. In and out. And every time you let go, you breathe out. Let go a little bit more of your body and your thoughts. I'll bring you back when it's time. Thank you. Bring your attention back to your breath. Without changing your breath, just notice how the breath flows into the body and out of the body. In and out. Now start to deepen your breath. Pull it a little bit deeper into your belly, your ribs, and your chest. And as you exhale, pull that belly button back towards the spine and bring all the air out of your body. Deep inhale, inflate that belly, ribs, and chest. Exhale, press all the air out of your body. Start to wiggle your fingers, your toes, roll through your wrists. Bring your feet together, reach them towards me, and your arms overhead, reach towards the hotel. Good morning. Oh, bring your knees into your chest, give yourself a little hug. See how that lower back feels. And then roll over to your favorite side. Keep your eyes closed. Check in with your body one more time. And then with your eyes closed, come back to a seated position. Once you arrive in your seat, close your eyes. With your next inhale, bring your arms out to the side, slowly up with one big inhale. Maybe a little smile on your face. And with your exhale, hands come in front of your chest. Go back to that intention of yours that you said at the beginning of class. Feel that intention in your heart space. You can make a choice here to carry that intention with you for the rest of the day, for the rest of the week. We'll close the class together with one chant of Aum and three Shanti. Deep inhale. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Aum, peace, peace, peace. Peace to your body, peace to your mind, peace to your soul, peace to you, peace to your loved ones, peace to the world. Thank you so much for allowing me to guide you through your practice this morning. You did absolutely amazing, yogis. Welcome back. Namaste.